שבוע טוב. פרשת ראה. ראה is a continuity of משה רבנו last speech. It lasted for 37 days. From ראש חודש שבט until זין באדר. The first pasuk says, ראה אנוכי נותן לפניכם היום ברכה וקללה. See, I present before you today a blessing and a curse. I want to ask you a few questions. Question number one. It looks like that there is a choice that I have to make. But the choice is a very weird choice. Somebody asks you in a restaurant, I can offer you a nice food or poison food. What would you like? It's a question that the answer is obvious. So why it's come on the world of on the matter of option? Who will agree to say, give me poison, please? A normal person. Another question, those of you who know Hebrew, the word re'eh,
singular.
Re'eh has all kinds of other words that have the same meaning. Habet, tzfe, istakel, hashkef, itbonen, avchen, and all others. Why did the Torah use the word re'eh, to see? And the first answer, the answer is very simple. I had somebody come to speak to me this week, and he asked me a question. And he told me that he had a problem with his lungs, but he likes smoking. So I told him, so you have to quit smoking. He said, yes, I cannot quit smoking. I told him, but it's not good for you. He told me, I have no choice. I told him, but something wrong is going to happen to you. He said, I don't know what to tell you. What happened to this power of will? He's been paralyzed. He doesn't have decisions anymore. He's been guided by the cigarettes. This is an extreme case when a person is going to make actions that are going to hurt him, but he won't have no control on this. So Moshe Rabbeinu is warning us. You asked me before, Aaron, what is Moshe Rabbeinu adding? One of the adding that Moshe Rabbeinu is adding in our parasha is adding the idea of be aware of the danger that sometimes you might lack your common sense and brain, and you're going to look at the bad thing that is good, and the good thing is bad. In this case of this boy, unfortunately, it's a problem of addiction. But the other thing, people will decide to will go to this direction, even though it's written on the pack that he's buying, it's not good for your health. There are all kinds of slogans over there against it. It doesn't mean anything. Because this person doesn't use his power of choice. And for him, the poison becomes a way of life. But this was the easy part of the pursuit. Why the Torah talks about see, why we say it in Hebrew, Re'eh. So, for this I will take you a small journey in the depth of our Torah. The Mefarshim says that the first time that everything, every word written in the Torah has a certain meaning about the entire understanding of this. What is the first time that we have the word lirot, vayar, vayera in the Torah. At the beginning, after God made the creation of the light, it says, Vayar Elohim et ha'or ki tov. And God saw the light, which is good. How Rashi explains it? He says, we have to use over here Agada. מה אגדה? ראו שאינו כדאי להשתמש בו רשעים. השם saw that the light, רשעים, it's not good that they're using it. והבדילו לצדיקים, לעתיד לבוא. I will get along with I believe that Rashi is telling us over here, Midrash Agada, very deep one. He say that in Hebrew to see is to see it with the light of Hashem, or to see it without the light of Hashem. To see is not to look. To see is not to observe. To see it is the to see it, Rami Rashi, v'yivdilo letzadikim. Rashiim can do it too with their own light. And I will explain the first understanding. Somebody takes a torch with red light and scream the wall. You're going to see a red wall. Somebody will take a green torch, you're going to see a green wall. So to see in Hebrew mean not to see just the wall, to see the wall with the light of the wall. This is the first thing. Let's continue. At the end of the creation of the world, it says on Friday, Vayar Elohim et kol asher asah, and Hashem saw the entire creation. No? Simulat. Vayar Elohim et kol asher asah, v'hineh tov meod. Now it's become not just good, it became excellent. The Midrash Rabbah brings on this a very interesting thing. He says, מה זה נקרא? You remember מה זה נקרא? וירא אלוקים, והנה טוב מאוד. מה זה הטוב מאוד הזה? Oh, אומר, זה כתוב, יהיה טוב מאוד, יצר הרע. מה זה יצר הרע? What's so good in יצר? אז הוא אומר, וירא אלוקים כל אשר עשה והנה טוב מאוד. הוא מביא כאן בראשית רבה בפרשת ט, והנה טוב מאוד זה יצר הרע. אומרת הגמרא, וכי יצרה טוב מאוד, אלא שאילולא יצרה לא בנה אדם בית ולא נשא אישה ולא הוליד ונשא וכו' וכו'. It's a side issue, but when Hashem, according to our understanding, when all the creation was created, Hashem put the Yetzer Hara, the evil in the world, it has to do one thing. What it has to do? It has to give her the freedom of choice, to see the light of the good, of the first light of the world, or the light of the Yetzer Hara. The last, what Hashem saw in the creation of the world. Again, the first time Hashem created the light,
it was good.
Is the good, the light of tzaddikim. the last light of the creation, Tov Me'od, is the perfection of this world, who makes it what?
Tov
Me'od. Tov Me'od. How it's working together?
It's a challenge.
Ve'e anochi noten lifnechem hayom bracha u'kala. I give you two magnifying glasses that you should choose. And both of them inside the creation. And I will explain before we go, if we continue. It says in the Holy Books that the world, and there is, in the spiritual world, we divide the world to four main worlds: Atzilut, Briya, Yetzira, Asiya. We are at the end of Olam Asiya. Atzilut, Briya, Yetzira is worlds of all kind of angels. What is the beauty of these angels? They're doing what Hashem is telling them. What is the not nice part of this? They don't have no Yetzirah. They ask him to Chez, Chez, Shin, Shin, Zay, Zay, Mu, Mu. When it's come to our world, this world is called Olam
HaAsiya.
Olam HaAsiya, Olam HaBechina. Hashem is testing us. In order to test us, what he has to do? Give us a choice. How you make the choice? You have to bring this way or this way. And you have to choose one. If I will not give you, if Hashem doesn't give us the power of choice, when we come to heaven, what do we say to HaKadosh Baruch Hu? We want to go to Gan Eden. Why? What choice we have? There is even a halachically aspect, Tinok Shenishba Ben Aguim. You know what it means?
No choice.
Roman. There was in World War II, religious family, the German came and took them. There was one young girl, they gave to the neighbor to raise. And then they disappeared. They never told to them, the neighbors never told them how much were the parents, who are they. She told they are the parents. So she grew up like Natasha, She got married to a boy. She had children. All of them were baptized. And she died like a good Christian woman. When she comes to heaven, they reveal to her the fact that what?
She was Jewish.
And she was Jewish. She never kept Shabbat, never kept Kashrut, never kept Yom Kippur, nothing. In this case, we say she doesn't have Gehenom. She has Gan Eden. Why?
No.
She has no choice. The only way to punish a person in heaven is when he has a choice. If you don't have a choice, to punish you of what? You get what I'm saying?
Yes.
So, the first creation of the world is in the light, Vayah Hashem Ki Tov. Hashem brought the light for tzaddikim. At the end of the creation, Vayah Hashem v'hineh tov me'od omer yetzara, Hashem brought the light of the world to Rasha'im, the yetzara. Now we are going again among these two lights, between these two lights. Good and bad, good and bad. You have to see now. Don't just see the reality. You have to see the light of the reality. And I will explain because it looks to you like a bit Chinese. We'll go about another major event in the history, the first scene of the history.
For the love?
Yes.
The light that we're saying that we kept for the tzaddikim.
Yes.
The Baruch Sholam, with this light, is too good to be in the world?
What?
The Baruch Sholam, this light was too good to be the world, for the world.
I told you, the light is in the Torah. Chen HaTorah Nikrit Or. And you have the right to see through the Torah the light of the world, and you have the choice not to live by the Torah. And then all our life is going to be based on the channel 1, 2, 3, ABC, NBC, whatever the channel.
So the light of the Torah that you go to the world.
This is the hidden light.
The hidden light.
This is the hidden light.
Now
we'll get there. Now we'll get there slowly, slowly. You're going to Kabbalistic issue. I'm talking about over here in the philosophical thing. The snake talks to the woman and tell her, and she told him about the God prohibition, the God command that what you should not eat from the tree. And he started to talk to her about how it's good and how it's. And then he says, "Vatere aisha ki tov ha'etz le'ma'achal," and the woman saw that the tree is delicious, good. תראו מה אומר רש"י. אז רש"י כתב את הדברים שלו ברוח הקודש. ראתה דבריו של נחש. She saw the words of the snake. I want to ask you, Boris, is it a good grammar to saw the, to saw the, she saw the words of the snake. מבינים מה שאני אומר? אומר הספרי חכמים פה, הוא אומר, מה קשה לרשי? Why רשי is so difficult? He said, רשי, he said, what she happened now? She saw this tree so long. What happened now? אומר רשי, she saw the words of the snake. Meaning, did she see the tree? No. She saw the tree in the light of the snake. Now it's totally different thing. And so the word to see, re'eh, is not just to look. Re'eh mean, in Hebrew mean, you see it with something. I'll tell you another example that I saw today, something that those of you who know Hebrew will agree with me. He says that. Vayaveh el Adam lirot, Hashem took all the animals and brought to Adam lirot ma yikra lo, v'chol asher yikra lo nefesh chaya u'shmo. The translation in English. And Hashem brought the animals and all the creation to the man to see how he's going to name them, and whatever he named them became their name. So is it testing him or is it appointing him? You get my question?
Testing.
No.
Simultaneously.
צריך להגיד ככה, ויאבה אל האדם, ויקרא שמות. And he called them names. No. ויאבה אל האדם לראות מה יקרה לו.
He was testing him to see his intelligence.
What? You call him and say, "Okay, let Moishele, let's do it." What's over here? What he has to see exactly? What he has to see?
The nature of each animal.
Oh, he doesn't have to. He has to see the animal. He has to see the potential. Say, "Ze chamor, ze sus, ze kelev. This is a dog. This is a donkey. This is a horse." Look at two, and he brought him to name the tzeh. He say, "Lirot ma yikra lo." וכל אשר יקרא לו אדם נפש חיה ושמו. אומר רשי סרסאו ופרשאו כל נפש חיה וכולי. It's a very difficult. You want to name children, you want to name the animals? Say, and Hashem brought the animals and Adam called them names. Finish. תראו איך הפסוק הזה בנוי. ויבא את האלה אדם לראות. And he brought the animals to see how he's going to name them. And whatever he named them, and then after it says the second pasuk, and Adam called names to all the animals and finished. So what is going on over here? What is to see in English? I try to tell you the word to see is not just to look and say, "Oh, it's a nice picture. Oh, it's a nice wall." No. To see, you have to see, you say potential, you see the light, you say the future, you say the past, something. It has to be something together with what you see. זה הראייה של תורה, אם יש לנו את זה.
זה לבחון.
מה אתה אומר?
לבחון. הוא בחן את החיות, לפי זה הוא נתן להם שיבות. לבחון.
מי בחן את מי?
הוא בחן את החיות.
איך אתה מסביר בעברית, ויבא אל האדם לראות מה יקרה לו?
כאילו שהשם יראה מה
הוא. ככה זה הפשט, נכון? ומה שתקרא לו, נפש חיה ושמו, זה הפסוק השני אומר, ויקרא האדם שמות לכל הבהמה. בסדר, מה נצא את הפסוק הראשון?
כל הרב, we know that angels, when they come, say, we created all that, and when he asked them to name, they couldn't. So we see, he testing. Hashem was testing Adam, and he tested angels. He wanted to see how intelligent Adam Rishon is.
So you see that the word to see
is
not just to look.
Right.
That the word to see in Hebrew has a very deep meaning.
To understand each animal's...
to go to everything, to go around, to go beyond, to go through, to see what's parallel. It's not what you see.
Mm-hmm.
We're saying that national anthem, oh, see what you see. This is the thing, to see inside the America, the culture of America, yes. Oh, עכשיו, this go over here, and then, שיהיה בריא, בוריס, הוא ראה משהו. The biggest place, they're talking about לראות, לא לראות, everything is this, and what Boris has said, זה עקדת יצחק. This is the place in the Torah. הכל שם רואה, השם יראה, הוא ראה, זה ראה, הוא הלך, תראה, לא תראה, שאלוהים, הכל יראה מה יראה. And from this I think that you have to look to right, you saw something,
זה תחיל את
הבריאה. Listen, מה זה נקרא לראות? He said it like this. By the way, before we get over there, you remember that Abraham is sending the Agar without water, or with water, the water will finish. כתוב ככה, ויפקח אלוהים את עניה ותראה באר מים. And Hashem opened her eyes and she saw the way. Wasn't it before? It was before. Did she see it? No. Why not? Because there was a certain curtain.
Screen.
There was a certain screen. Binding. So lirot is when you're able to see something through something. The word lirot is something, it's not just a simple look. Something is it's a deeper than this. אבל בואו באמת נראה מה כתוב פה. It says that Abraham is taking Yitzchak, Ishmael, and Eliezer, and he says, ביום השלישי, וישא אברהם את עיניו, וירא את המקום הרחוק. And Abraham saw the place. He saw it from far away. מה אומר רש"י? מה זה את המקום הרחוק? רש"י say, he saw a cloud on the mountain. בסדר? דל צחינים בעלי התוספות. When Abraham saw the cloud, he told to Yitzchak, what do you see, my son? He said, it's a beautiful mountain and a nice cloud over there. He asked Ishmael, who Amar, I see the mountain. And Eliezer saw, he saw just the mountain. Amar him Abraham, so you will sit here and I will go with Yitzchak. What does it mean? They look at one place, three people, believe in Hashem, highly educated people, the best of Abraham Avinu, and they don't see what he's seeing.
נכון? כן, but only there they can't clear for Abraham. מי זה יצחק ומי זה...
I open in Midrash Rabbah, if you remember, without Hashem, in a month it's going to be Rosh Hashanah, the beautiful Mizmor of Et Sha'arei Ratzon, כתוב, הראיתם הור, אור מהר המור. Did you see the light from the mountain? Rashi brings over here that it was a cloud. נכון? So the בחידושי הרב דוד לוריה, he brings over here and he says that he saw בפרקי רבי אליעזר שכתוב שם, it was a pillar of fire from the land to heaven, from heaven to earth. So what did he see? We don't know, but we know they saw something. Rashi said it was a cloud. Rabbi Elazar said it was a huge pillar of fire that combines heaven and earth. It was so. So it was not just to see a cloud. It's to see a whole fire that Eliezer and Ishmael could not see. לכן כתוב, now we have to, let's go on this, it's beautiful over here the way. Then Abraham is taking Itzhak, he takes the wood and he takes the fire. What is missing? The korban, נכון? So Itzhak is asking his father. What is asking him?
See, I see fire, I see wood, but where is the olah?
Yes, the olah.
אז מה אומר לו אברהם? אלוהים יראה לו. אומר רש"י, ואם אין שה לעולה בני, ואף על פי שהבין יצחק שהוא הולך להישחט, וילכו שנים יחדיו. אברהם אומר ליצחק, if you ask me this question, something is wrong with you. You don't have to ask question, you know, it's... אלוהים יראה לו, it's obvious, you know, everything is so obvious. He has to be died enough and now, it's so obvious, you know, you have to take it with שמחה, like nothing happened. This you have to be, you know, it's... התרגום אומר, מה זה אלוהים יראה לו? ויאמר השם, גלה לאמרה לעלתה בריא. אברהם says, אלוהים, please, the midrash says, אברהם says, Hashem will choose the right one. Baba Abraham, Hashem yivchar le. But the idea of you have to see, tell to Yitzhak, you have to see, don't ask questions. So it's a certain thing. By the way, this is the only time in the history that we quote a dialogue between Abraham and Yitzhak.
We quote what?
A dialogue between Abraham and Yitzhak. Never spoke in the Torah. תמיד זה אברהם ואליעזר, אברהם ושרה, אברהם והשם יצחק, all the time, going to Gan Eden, come from heaven, come from this, his wife come home, nothing. The only words, the only time that אברהם speak to יצחק, יצחק is, אבא, where is the sheep? He said, you have to look for it.
הוא לא שואל,
where is the
sheep? הוא יודע מה קורה, הוא רוצה לדעת, so which means, don't talk with him.
I know, it's a different thing. But this, okay, this... But now let's go to the place. After the Akedah, Hashem is telling him, everything is okay, כתוב, ויקרא אברהם שם המקום ההוא, Hashem יראה. Hashem will see. רש"י, Hashem saw, למה Hashem will see? כתרגומו אומר רש"י, Hashem יבחר ויראה לו את המקום הזה, להכיר שכינתו. אשר יאמר היום בהר Hashem יראה. What is the, what is the, מה זה נקרא השם יראה? מה צריך לראות פה? So I was thinking to say today a new pshat in this. There is a nice rabbi in Brooklyn, rabbi in Mumbai, if you wrote a nice book, he wrote the Mashiach. Chori? And he says something like this. He says that people used to go to Yerushalayim in time Beit HaMikdash. They used to see so many miracles that they have to be blind not to see it. And many people didn't see it, unfortunately. He gives an example. Once, in Masechet Pesachim, the Gemara brings about, they said, Agribas HaMelech, you want to know how many Korbanot Pesach were brought this year to Beit HaMikdash. And they count from each korban one kidney. One kidney. And they count 1.2 million korbanot Pesach. One Pesach. Second temple. 1.2 million korbanot Pesach. And because every family it has to be at least 10 people, talk about 12 million people in Yerushalayim. You know, Yerushalayim inside the walls is not such big to put 1.5 times all the people in Israel in one small place. So 10 days of Pesach, 12 million people in Yerushalayim, and nobody felt that he's missing, congested, that he's missing his space. It says that in the Gemara Masechet Eruvin that every person has to eat every day at least 2 kilograms of food, like what the man came from heaven. It means that they have to be prepared for these people 240 million kilograms, or 250 million tons of food.
2.4
a day. And for in Beit HaMikdash, for the day, the Arba Kosot, Kedush Vahavdalah, we're talking about 12 million liters of wine, another 6 million liters of the Korbanot, so we just needed 18 million liters of wine for 10 days. Just for the statistic, today in all Eretz Israel, they're using 45 million liters a year. This is what they're using. So one half of this for 10 days in Yerushalayim, it was served to the people. When you bring Korban Pesach, you have to bring with this Korban Chagiga and Korban Aliyah, Korban Ola, and Korban Shlamim. So basically, we make an accounting that almost 5 million Korbanot for the first day of Pesach. The Ramban brings that he has to bring Shalmei Todah gam ken, so it makes it 6 million Shalmei Todah. With all the accountings of all the Korbanot, they made that for the Chag, they used to bring 24 million animals to sacrifice.
Wow.
The Mizbech was this, about half of this was the Mizbech. And you have to know that they have to be, you should not left until after midnight. It has to be burnt. In order to supply this, Chachamim asked people to come around Yerushalayim and to bring all the animals. And he says that they used to call Yerushalayim in the holiday, they used to call it the White Mountains. Because all the hills around Yerushalayim was white from the sheep and from the goats. Now, in Korban Pesach it says there were 66 lines of Kohanim to bring the to take the blood. Mm-hmm. So they used to put the Kohanim on ramps because about one foot of blood would cover the entire Beit HaMikdash. So they're making three times this Korban Pesach Shechita, which make it half a million sheep divided to 66 lines. It means that in 90 minutes they slaughter 8,000 animals. Meaning, every slaughtering of animal would last 2/3 of 1 second. For 90 minutes without no stopping. No talking, no stopping, no cell phone, no messages, nothing. And he takes it and he brings it to the next one. And the Gemara says that because of the speed of 2/3 of a second for one korban, it looks like two lines of gold and silver, because it was like a movie, you know. Like after they finish the slaughter, they have to clean the animal. They have to And everything has to be done on Yerushalayim. And they say that they were looking for tanurim, looking for
ovens.
And they say that never in Yerushalayim somebody didn't have an oven for his korban. How many ovens we need to bring 1.2 million korbanot? In the morning, people come to pray. We made an accounting that there was 4 minyanim, one after the other, in the Rachava Beit HaMikdash, on every square feet, need to stand 1,000 people. And none of them felt congested and has been pushed by somebody. 1,000 people per square foot. Now, after, when you bring the korban, you have to remember that you have to bring with this menachot. Menachot is flour, נכון? So the smallest account of menachot is about 5 pounds of flour. So we talk about over here, and of course you have to bring over here oil too. So if there was about 10 million average 10 million korbanot, we need 1,300 storages rooms for all of this. More than this, in order to take it, you have to come and pay in Beit HaMikdash, and for this you need, if you need 6 million people to this, you need it, if they are going to stay for 1 second, we need 1600 hours, 70 days to finish with them. Therefore it was the same, hundreds of people that were giving out, and still everything was so quick, it doesn't make sense. More than this, you have to burn on the Mizbeach, beside the Korbanot, 14 million pounds of kilograms of flour, 6 million liters of oil, and they say if you're going to put all this on the Mizbeach without burning it, you will go to 41 floors building. And it has to be burned in one day. It has to be finished. By midnight, nothing should be left over there. You have to add on the Mizbeach 2 million olot riyad. It has to be burned altogether on the Mizbeach. If you assume that at least weight of the korban is 20 kilograms per animal, we talk about a 40 million kilograms, 40,000 tons of meat that has to be burned in the same day. Plus the oil